We just crossed into Arizona a few minutes ago, and this morning we got some horrible news about one Shane McGowan, poet, singer for the Pogues. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant man. As I've joked many times, without Shane, I don't think I would have had a career. Or I would have been, it would have been a very short set list. Shane was instrumental in the way I performed, the way I sang, the way I ran, you know. Big, big, big influence. And personally, I was back in 80, I want to say it was 80, 86 when I heard Rome Sod Me in the Lash. My friend Stephen McGuinness from Ballybrack, County Dublin, Ireland, he introduced me to that record. And we played Sick Bed of Cuchulainn, first track. Remember, I'm into nothing but Iron Maiden, Black Sabbath, and Pain. So to hear Irish music played like that, and remember, Thin Lizzy had already done their Whiskey in a Jar and whatever, and Horselips were around, of course. But to hear it done with such brash punk rock attack, but still so melodic and so, the lyrics were so fierce, so original. I've never heard that before. Never heard anybody sing, "So you dropped a button in the plate and spewed up in the church." Ireland, 1986. That shit wasn't gonna fly. It did. So Shane, at that moment, had a grip on how I wanted to deliver music, you know. And Blackguards, just from my own personal standpoint, Shane McGowan was absolutely instrumental in just about every aspect of this band. Owe him a huge, huge, huge debt. So it's a big loss for me personally.
There's people out there that play what they like, and there's people out there that play what somebody else likes, and he played what he liked.
Yeah.
And he's a pioneer, you know. He cleared the path for many people.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still trying to process the news today, right? You know, it's like you don't expect it, but man, very grateful for everything that he did.
He's one of the greatest poets in rock. Really would put him up there with the best, like the Dylans and the Coens and,
yeah,
you know.
And Springsteen was a huge fan.
Yeah.
Joe Strummer was a huge fan. All these people that are just icons, you know, they all look to him. Just Nick Cave. All these people look to Shane for, you know, that's the guy. And he was, you can see old punk rock videos where Shane's in the front row. Huge music fan. I got to see Shane McGowan and the Popes in Austin, La Zona Rosa. I wish I could tell you, well, I'm going to say exactly how he opened the show, and then we're going to bleep it. Two words that I fucking detest. But he opened the show in Austin, Texas. First thing out of his mouth, "Are you ready to bleep?" He said, "I hope there's no d***s here." And I'm sat there going,
and then he did his laugh, right?
Yeah. the Bert and Ernie. And I just stood there. There's these two huge fucking Hispanic guys in front of me. I'm going, how's that? They're laughing. And I'm going, okay. Jesus Christ, Shane. He wrote and he sang and he lived, you know, right or wrong. That's how he did it.
I mean, who knows what the context may have been, some conversation they had before they went on about racist attitudes in the region or something.
Yeah, of course, you don't know with
not
him.
That, yeah.
Yeah, he's not Phil Anselmo from Pantera.
Right.
A great friend of his is a young fellow named Johnny Depp. He's an up-and-comer. You might hear him. Johnny Depp's stories, his Shane stories, are just fucking epic. I mean, stratospheric, monstrous. He and Shane shared many a bottle of alcohol. And they're both excruciatingly deep thinkers. You know, Johnny Depp's love for Shane comes through in his, because I was like, nah, he's a poser, he wants to be, but he's not only a fan, but a close friend of Shane's. And to hear these stories really takes you into Shane's mind, and you can't discount that guy. You can never as out of it as he looked or sounded, his mind was razor sharp. And that show in Austin, so we're outside the venue, and there's all these rumors going around that Shane's not coming. He's not feeling it tonight, not showing up, which had happened a few shows on the tour. And we're just like, fuck. So we're all standing outside, and the people are getting phone calls and stuff, you know, like, is it happening? Is he? Yeah, he's here. No, he's not. Not coming. And you just hear these things just bouncing through the crowd. And I knew back then it was such a gift to be able to see him perform. You know, so when he showed up and he played that night and he put on the show that he put on, just so thrilled, so amazed to be able to have seen that. I cherish that.
Was that with those two times we saw the Pogues? Was that the only time you saw?
That was the only time I saw the Pogues. Yeah. Houston and Austin. Yeah.
That was great that we were able to see both of those.
Yeah. And again, he was spot on.
Yeah.
Didn't miss a fucking lyric.
No.
And he, you know, he, some of his banter, some of his little things he'd drop in and out of the, you know, in between the songs would be incoherent or something. But man, when he started to sing,
yeah,
you're listening to the record.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh my God. And there was a rumor too that if he didn't show, he didn't get paid for the tour. There was some kind of, hey, don't fuck around.
Yeah.
Thing, you know, but he was just in great form.
Yeah.
And it was such a, you really felt like you were in the presence of greatness, who you are.
Yeah. And those were both such great shows. Obviously, the second one in Houston was better for us because it wasn't raining. Honestly, we were way closer to the stage than we were at Stubbs.
Where did you see him in Houston? What was the place?
House of Blues. House of Blues. I think it was the first time I'd gone there.
Oh, that did.
And it was great. Cool. Yeah, he was, Shane was very composed and relatively sober, like for both of those shows, right up until like the last few songs, and then he had a bottle of Jameson in his hand, I think.
So yeah, we're processing this today, and it's you know, he definitely won't be forgotten. He's so beloved across this planet, and the music is so timeless. That sometimes even feels shallow saying that because it's not enough. I remember one time him laughing, doing the thing, because some of the critics had said, well, you just take Irish tunes and you put lyrics to them. Can't be that. And he's like, you fucking do it. Yeah. He didn't give a fuck, but at the same time, he was just like, you try it. And it's not easy.
No, there's nobody. I mean, there really is nobody else who even comes close to that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just so many bands have tried to imitate him, and it's all the drink.
Yes.
Guys don't. There's way more to this stuff than
that. Listen, you're missing it.
Yeah.
Anyway, so, rest in peace, Shane. November 30th, 2023. Sad day. You made it to this time next month. You would have made it to his birthday, born on Christmas Day. Maybe we'll chuck our fairy tale of New York at the end of this. It's our little tribute to Shane McGowan. And of course, Kiersey McCall. Anyway.
God bless you, Shane.
Yeah, cheers.
It was Christmas Eve, babe. In the drunk tank, an old man said to me, won't see another one. So then we sang a song, the rare old mountain dew. I turned my face away and dreamed about you. Got on the lucky one, came in 18 to 1. I've got a feeling this year's for me and you. So happy Christmas. I love you, baby. I can see a better time when all our dreams come true. Queen of New York City. When the band finished playing, they howled out for more. Sinatra was swinging, all the drunks they were singing. We kissed on the corner and danced through the night. The boys of the NYPD choir were singing all the way back, and the bells were ringing out for Christmas Day. A joke, lying there almost dead in a drip and not bad.
You scumbag, you maggot, shit, lousy faggot. Happy Christmas, you're us, I pray God it's our last.
The boys of the NYPD choir were singing all the way back. with me, babe. I put down with my own, can't make it all alone. I built my dreams around you. The boys of the Empire beating choirs to singing Galway Bay, and the bells were ringing out for Christmas Day.